We got the HGK carbon Kevlar kit for weight purposes. It was 80 pounds lighter than the full carbon body that I had. In order to be legal to run this size tire, we had to roughly add 350 pounds to the car. So I got some 50 pound lead bricks. Typically around a course in the US, I'm about 10 seconds slower than any car. But if I drive anything else that's remotely close to what this could be, it kind of ends up throwing me off.
Can we just first of all cover some of the recent changes that you've made?
One of the big changes was adding weight to the car. In order to be legal to run this size tire, we had to weigh a certain amount of weight. And for us, it was 29.78. And we were running in the low 26s. So we had to roughly add 350 pounds to the car. Besides that, it's relatively the same as I ran it at Grid Life, Gingerman, and at Road Atlanta with some small stuff aero-wise, but that's really about it.
Adding that weight, how's that done? Ballast of some sort, I'm assuming you're adding it low on the car and where you want it?
Yeah, so I got some 50 pound lead bricks and added one of those below the transaxle and then the rest in the passenger seat. I tried originally to put it all in the rear to help it dig out of corners, and I went testing and it didn't really like that. It kind of just sent me right off track. I couldn't catch the rear end in time. Now I just put it all in the passenger seat and just kept that 50 pounds in the back.
Keeping the weight distribution where you want it and also the center of gravity as low as possible. Visually, the car's a bit of a different color to we saw at last. The body panels have changed. What's been done there?
We got the HGK carbon Kevlar kit. It's their drift body for weight purposes. It was 80 pounds lighter than the full carbon body that I had. On top of that, it looks great.
Yeah,
it
definitely looks really good. Made for drifting, carbon Kevlar. It's also pretty robust.
Yeah, I'd say. I mean, we're not trying to take any hits, but in drifting, they take some good hits.
How do you prepare to come to a new track? Are you using a simulator?
Yeah, so I have just like stuff off Amazon for a sim, but I really just use it to learn sight and part placement for the track. It's a totally different animal to drive this thing versus really anything on the sim. Sometimes I'll drive like the Indy car or something just to try to get me a little bit faster than what my car is doing. Typically around a course in the US, I'm about 10 seconds slower than Indy car. So it kind of gives me a little bit faster pace than what I need. But if I drive anything else that's remotely close to what this could be, it kind of ends up throwing me off. Typically Indy car driving would be the way to go on the sim to prep for the track.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Adjusting your brain for something a bit faster pace, so when you get to this, I wouldn't say it would be more relaxed, but digestible.
I mean, yeah, because you know, if you take it faster, then at least you can slow it down. Your hands are moving so quickly, your eyes are moving so fast and like looking so far ahead. If you're already training yourself to do that even further, then it's a lot easier to slow it down.
Just a bit of insight. For example, you come here, we have a testing day and then 2 days of competition. How many laps are you turning here before the competition starts?
It's tough, right? Because you make it all this way. You want to set decent pace in practice, but yet you don't want to hurt the car. It's a fine balance. You know, I ran it relatively on low boost. For the very last session, I ran it on 900 horsepower map, just to kind of get me like that mile per hour sensation into the corners, get my braking points a little bit more defined. You know, I'm still figuring it out. It's so tough, especially in competition, to come and try to figure out a track and be competitive. There couldn't be any more pressure on you. You know, when all these guys have been here and, you know, they've been here for years, they live here, run this track forever, it's a lot on someone who hasn't. So I'm just trying my best. Every time I go out, I pick a corner. I might perfect one and then I ruin the next. I don't know if I'll ever leave here really feeling like I got it, but maybe we can come back next year.
The nature of the vehicle, being a time attack vehicle, it's fairly high strung to run at a limit.
It's tough, right? So I tried to go out on a different set of tires earlier and they didn't suit the track well. And so now I'm just in conserve mode, right? Try to conserve what I have, but still make laps. Again, it's a fine balance.
In terms of setup and things like that, what would you expect when you come to a new track and adjust the car and kind of dial it in? I guess you have limited time to make those decisions as well.
I haven't made a single change to the car. So I haven't done anything with suspension at all. The only thing I changed was tires, and I went right back to what I had on it. I need to learn so much, right? All the changes I think if I made behind the wheel would benefit way more than trying to change the car. So I keep that consistent and just try to perfect myself on driving.
That makes a lot of sense. And coming here as a privateer, shipping the vehicle here, how do you decide what equipment and parts to bring? Is it a bit of a balancing act, I'm sure?
Man, that's a tough one, right? We were in a container of three, and we had a limited space to pack spares. So tires were a priority. So I sent tires, and I have these two like 50-gallon totes on wheels. And that was kind of it. Anything that I might have had failures in the past with, sensors, you know, little things that are hard to find, I just sent with a car, a lot of tools, and just random stuff, really. I didn't bring any big ticket items just because I didn't feel like we had the space. Also, the expense behind it, if I wanted to bring a spare engine, a spare trans, stuff like that. Luckily, my transmission PPG is Australia. They luckily had some spares here for me if need be. But I just figured, hey, you know, take it easy, make some laps, and if you can, save the boost for the very end. Or if I never feel comfortable enough and I never figure out, probably won't try to salvage a lap with boost.
And I guess it comes back to what you said before as well, with the foundations of the car being built to be a strong platform. So hopefully you're not making any major mechanical failures.
Hopefully not. We'll keep our fingers crossed.
Just one other thing we just discussed before. You've done some aero testing this morning on the vehicle. Can you just talk through that a little bit?
Oh yeah, it was so cool, man. Kyle Engineering came over and we chatted and he's like, yeah, I got Flow Viz if you want to Flow Viz the car. And I was like, that would be awesome. I've never spent wind tunnel time or nothing like that. So this is a Feras Engineering wing. He Flow-Vizzed it, and he Flow-Vizzed this diffuser, which originally was from DeSoul Designs, and I just made it out of his mold. There was like separation only where this tape is, because I use tape on everything. And there was just a slight bit of separation right in the middle here, but everything else was completely attached, and he's like, it couldn't get any better than this. So it's good to know that I chose the right company to work with to design this wing. And yeah, the homemade aero stuff that I thought would work is actually working.
Just to clarify, people who are not familiar with Flow Viz.
Paint that flows as you speed up and then it dries. So that way you can see and make sure like if it's attaching or not. So if airflow is attached, you'll see like streaks of the paint with it. And if it detaches or something, you'll see the separation marks of it.
Cool. Well, thanks for that. Thanks for your time. If people want to follow along with what you're doing, your journey, going to all these different tracks and running the vehicle, where are they best to do so?
I'd say I really just do everything on Instagram @Feras_Qartoumy.
Perfect. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, for sure. Thanks, man.